Chapter 3, Outward Appearance of Business Letter. We learned about the commercial communication and the meanings and types. We also learned about different styles of letter writing. Now let us learn the outward appearance of letter. If the outward appearance is not attractive, the receiver will be least interested in reading it, and that is going to affect our business. Now here we include envelope, superscription, quality of paper, its folds, typing, etc. So we have to take all these things into consideration. Matters that make the appearance of a letter attractive: paper, typing, margin, fold, envelope, superscription. Point is paper and its selection. We have to consider the three different angles: size, color and quality. Generally we use A4 size paper as there is a good space for presenting our write-ups. These days almost all countries follow the measurement of A series of paper size, and mostly we use size A4. Here we generally use the color, or we see that the paper color is no white. Certain firms do prefer pastel shades or light sky blue, yellow or pink color. Ink should not spread on the paper, and the while making punch, as we have to file it up, the paper's quality should be good, and so it does not threaten the possibility of tear. Second is typing. In the present time, commercial correspondence generally does not take place in the form of handwritten letters. So these letters are generally drafted on computer and printed. Handwritten letters have remained limited to writing of personal letters. Now the typing should be legible. For computer type letter, fonts of different types and size are available. Mostly for letters for correspondence purpose or for the business purpose, we use simple fonts and we use least cursive variation so that it is easy for the reader to understand what we have written. Proper care in typing should be done, because the elegance and brilliance that what we have written must be clear. In addition to that, line spacing adds attractive look to the letter. Mostly we use 1.0, 1.15 or 1.5 spacing between two lines. Third point is margin. Keeping margin and leaving space on all the four sides attributes beauty to a letter. Margins are kept on the left and right hand side of the paper, and left margin is kept larger as compared to the one of the right. Right margin is 1 inch broad and on left we have 1.5 inch. Commercial letters are to be filed and preserved, so letters need to be punched on the left to be filed. So therefore we keep more space towards the left side. Similar logic is applied for the top and the bottom. At the bottom it is generally 1 inch and top we keep 1.5 inch. But it's still our choice, because some writers prefer identical space pattern on top and bottom. Next topic is fold. When the paper is being folded, we have to see that it is not folded many times and compressed into a small envelope, because this is going to give a bad impression about the letter writer. So therefore we have to keep a common practice of folding a letter. The letter can be maximum, or it can be to an extent only three folds. First would be a vertical fold, so that we are covering the space spared for margin on the left. Thereafter, keeping into consideration the size of the paper, it has to give two or three horizontal fold. So this provides a convenience to the reader while he opens the envelope to read the letter, and also when it is point is envelope. As the content of the letter is similarly, sometimes with the letter, many other papers will be enclosed with it. In such a case, we cannot use a small size envelope. Rectangle and vertical envelope is used for business letter. The paper of the envelope should match with the higher quality paper and shade of the paper used for letter writing. This gives an attractive look. If paper is white, envelope should be white. If it is a pastel shade, then envelope should also match. Certain firms, banks and LIC use window envelope to dispatch, especially receipts. Here, a window is made by cutting the portion where receiver's address is visible. The inside address is clearly read over here. It has been folded in such a manner that through window or from that transparent paper, we can read the receiver's address. So for receiver it is easy, and for the sender also there is no need to waste time by putting the address on the envelope. But for confidential matter, this window envelopes are not used. Superscription. Under this superscription, what is written on the envelope is been mentioned. Now we know that receiver as well as writer's address and pin codes are written. Top middle part, dispatchment of letter like book post, register ID, local, personal, these are written. Thereafter, towards the right hand side, the receiver's name, address, name, place, pin code, etc. is written. The writer's address is generally printed in the lower horizontal band or written in the left down corner. When there is an invitation letter or circular, or these things are dispatched, invitation letter or circular, the sender's address is printed at the back of the envelope.